My dear brothers and sisters here at Lusaka Central Congregation and all the connected congregations.
Okondedwa abale ndialongo anga kuno kumpingo wa Lusaka Central dimpingo yose yolumikizidwa.
Hearty welcome to this live transmission of the divine service to be conducted by our dear District Apostle Kububa Soko.
Tikulandira ndi mtima wose kukufalisidwa kwa mapempero oyera aba omwe azatengedwa ndi okondedwa mtumwi wathu wa chigawo Kububa Soko.
We are broadcasting via the free to air set top boxes.
Tifalisa mapempero aba mukaboko sikofalisa kose kose.
On YouTube, Facebook Live and telephone, as well as radio and internet radio.
Pa Facebook, pa YouTube, diponso ndi pa wireless, ndi njiraso ya wireless ya kachisi katumi asopano.
Through the New Apostolic Church TV channel in Cape Town, South Africa.
Kupiorera munjira ya kachisi kasopano ku South Africa, mzinda wa Cape Town.
The District Apostle and his entourage have arrived here at Central Church Congregation.
Okondedwa mtumwi wathu wa chigawo wafika kale ndiyo omwe abwera nawo mulendo wache kuno kumpingo wa Lusaka Central.
He is accompanied by District Apostle Helper Robert Nsamba.
Mulendo wache wabwera ndi mtandizili wa mtumwi wa chigawo Robert Nsamba.
Apostle Daniel Mulemba from Zimbabwe.
Mutumwi Daniel Mulemba kuchokera ku Zimbabwe.
Apostle Owen Kaira from Malawi.
Mutumwi Owen Kaira kuchokera ku Malawi.
And the host Apostle Oscar Kalumiana.
Ndi mutumwi mwini malo ano Oscar Kalumiana.
This live broadcast of divine service will be conducted in English.
Kufarisa kwa mapempero oyera aba kuzakhala mu mtundu wa Chingerezi.
And interpreted in Chinyanja at the altar.
Na masuliridwa mchinyanja pano pagua.
And also into sign language.
Dimutundu wazisonyezo.
The divine service is scheduled to start at 9 hours.
Mapempero ayamba ndi nthawi ya 9 koloko.
Congregational hymns for this divine service are.
Zinyimbo zogwirisira ntchito mapempero oyera abazayimbidwa ndi mpingo ndizi.
Opening hymn, Come Everyone and Join Our Song.
Nyimbo tsogira mapempero ndi idzani nonse tizayanjane munyimbo yathu.
365 in New English Hymnal.
365 mu kabuku kathu ka Chingerezi kasopano.
The hymn of repentance is I Want a Principle Within.
Nyimbo yakulapa ndi akuti ndifuna nsonga.
322 in the New English Hymnal.
322 mukabuku katuka kachisika tumaso pano kachingerezi.
The two hymns for Holy Communion are.
Nyimbo zomwe zaimbidwa polandira mgonero ndizi.
The first one is There Is a Fountain, 336.
Yoyamba ndi nyimbo ikuli kasupe, nyimbo 366.
336.
Nyimbo 336.
In the New English Hymnal.
Mukabuku kachingerezi ka kachisi watu kasopano.
Then Fresh from the Throne.
Zochokera kwa mbuye.
279.
279.
In the New English Hymnal.
Mukabuku kachingerezi ka kachisi watu kasopano.
For Serving the Departed.
Paku tumikira iwani mara mtsidia.
We shall first have the hymn, Oh, the Home of My Soul.
Tizaimba nyimbo yoyamba, mudzi wa moyo wanga.
447 in the New English Hymnal.
447 mukabuku kasopano kachingerezi kakachisi watu watumwi wasopano.
The second hymn will be Peace the God Has Given.
Yachiwiri ndi mtendere omwe Mulungu wapatsa.
This will be rendered by violin and organ.
Izaimbidwa ndi wa kabanjo ndi wa organ.
391 in the New English Hymnal.
391 mukabuku kasopano kachingerezi.
Our text word for this divine service will come out of the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 4.
Sopano lemba lomwe lizagwirisidwa nchito mapempero oyera aba lizachokera mbuku la Filipo samba la 4 ndi chigawo cha 4.
Thank you.
Zikomo.
Thank you.
My dear brothers and sisters here at Lusaka Central Congregation and all the connected congregations.
O kondedwa bale ndialongo anga kuno kumpingo Lusaka Central ndiyo semipingo yolumikizidwa.
I ask you to rise and join in the opening hymn for the commencement of the divine service.
Ndikupempani kuti munyamuke tianjane munyimbo mapempero ayamba.
Oh, Let us pray.
Tieni tipempere.
In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Muzina la mulungu, atate mwana ndi mzimu oyera.
Almighty God, our loving Father in heaven. Together we come before you with humbleness and gratitude.
Limozi tisa pamaso panu na tili nako kuzichepetsa ndiposo ndikuyamikira.
We've come to worship you.
Tadza kudza kupembedzani.
We've come to adore you.
Tadza kudza kulemekezani.
We've come to glorify your name.
Tadza kuzabwelesa ulemelero kwa inu.
For we know, Father, that you are the creator of heaven and earth.
Chifukwa tidziwa Atate kuti inu ndinu nyamalenga wa dziko la pansi ndi mnyamba.
We also believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, the one you sent to die for us.
Tibvomeranso mwa mwana wanu Yesu Kristu, iyemwe munatuma kuzatifera
ife. We believe that he will come to take us home.
Tibvomeranso kuti azadza na adzatiketengera kumudzi.
We believe in the Holy Spirit you gave us.
Tikurupirira mwa mzimu oyera munatipatsa.
That he is preparing us for the return of your Son Jesus Christ.
Iye atikonza kamba kakubweranso kwa mwana wanu Yesu Kristu.
So thank you for your grace. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the protection. And thank you for the great future which you have prepared for us. And that great future is for us to be with you and your Son Jesus Christ in eternity. And so we've come, Father, so that we can prepare ourselves for that great future. So touch us with your word, that we may grow into the nature and the character of your Son, Jesus Christ. Together we pray for those that are passing through various difficulties. You know them, Father, and you know where they are. There are those that are sick in homes and in hospitals. There are those that are mourning because they have lost their beloved ones. There are those that are neglected and rejected in the society. And
in
many categories thereof. Please, Father, be with them. And let them not feel forgotten on account of what they are passing through. And now we seek to be joined by the souls from the beyond. The redeemed souls that are waiting for the return of your Son, Jesus Christ. Just as we are also waiting. Let them join us, Father, so that we can celebrate this divine service together. Now we pray for the successful transmission to the congregations that are connected. Let everything be as scheduled. And now permit also the good wishes and prayers of the chief apostle, who is fully aware about this divine service to cover us. We cannot put everything in word. Give us much more than we can ask. Hear us, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord, and to all those connected to this divine service this morning. First of all, I want to bring to you love and greetings from our dear chief apostle. I had a discussion with him last evening. And through his greetings, I want to lay in your hearts the peace and love of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now the word from the chief apostle on this fourth and final Sunday of Advent.
Mawato chokera kwa mtumwa wa mkuru pa sabata ili la chinai limene lilo malizira.
From the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 4.
Chokera mbuku la Filipo, samba la fondi chigao cha 4.
Rejoice in the Lord always.
Kondwerani mwa ambuye ntawi zose.
Again, I will say rejoice.
Ndibwezeranso kutero kuti kondwerani.
That is the word.
Ndiroli ulatu ilu.
Thank you, choir, the conductor, and the orchestra.
Zikomo oimba, oliza vilimba, ndi oimbitsa yemwe.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord.
Okondedwa abale ndi alongo anga mwa Ambuye.
The choir talks about soon comes the day.
Oimba, aimba nyimbo, ndi kunena kuti siku lilimkudza mosa chedwa.
And which is this day?
It's
a day when our Lord Jesus Christ will return to take us home.
Ndilo siku limene ambuye wathu Yesu Kristu azabwera so kuzatitengera kumudzi.
And our desire is that when he comes, he can find us ready.
Chirakola kocha tundicha kuti pomwe yazabwera akatipeze tiri okonzeka.
And when we go for divine services like this one,
monga tipita kumapempero oyera monga aba.
Our desire should be that we should be molded into the nature and the character of Jesus Christ.
Chirakola kocha tuchikhale chakuti tikhale akukonzedwa ndi kuumbidwa mu msiku ndi mkhalidwa mbiya wathu Yesu Kristo.
So that when he comes, he can find us ready.
Kuti pomwe iyazabwera akatipeze tiri okonzeka.
And now the word which we've been given this morning.
So pano liundi lomwe tapatsidwa mabamunu.
It's a text taken from the closing chapter of the letter which Apostle Paul wrote to the congregation in Philippi.
So pano ndi mawu ochokera mukhalata yomalizira omwenso mtumwi Paulo analemba kwa Filipo.
The congregation there found itself in a situation of distress.
So pano mpingo komwe kuja unakhala ndi kuzipeza mukhalidwe omwe ali osakhala bwino.
Because there was opposition from the state authorities as well as from the society.
Kunali kususana kuchokera kwa iwo tsogolera dziko ndi kwa ena amzina.
There was also an emergence of some Christians who were preaching false doctrine.
Kunadzukaso apunzisi omwe anali kupunzisa chipunziso cha chilendo chosayenera.
And this caused divisions and uncertainty in the church.
So pano ichi chinakhala ndi kubweresa mpatuko na bweresanso kusowa kukhala ndi chikaiko.
So Apostle Paul decided to write a letter so that he could comfort the Christians.
So pano mtumi Paulo anagamula kulemba kalata kuti akhale ndi kutontoza mpingo.
And these words we've heard this morning, that rejoice always in the Lord. Again, I say rejoice. Now, joy is not a mental state which can be commanded.
So pano chikondwerero si chinthu chopezeka mutu chimene munthu angakhale ndi kunena kuti chikhale ndi kupezeka.
There must be something to trigger this joy.
Kwena ukhala china chinthu chimene chidzetsa chikondwererochi.
On earth we've got a lot of things that can bring joy to us.
Padziko lapansi tilinazo zinthu zambiri mbiri zomwe zingathe kutikondweretsa.
Maybe we are enjoying health. There is good health.
Mwina mwacha uli ndi thanzi labwino.
You rejoice.
Ukhala wakukondwa.
Sometimes you are engaged in some business.
Tawizina uchita za malonda.
And that business is booming.
Malondao atukuka.
You rejoice.
Ukhala wakusangala, kondwera.
Maybe you are not employed, now you are employed.
Mwina mwache unalibe nchito, lero lino wapeza nchito.
You are earning a salary at the end of the month.
Mapeto amwezi ukhala ndi kupasidwa kobiri.
You rejoice.
Ukhala
wakukondwera. Because you are employed.
Chifukwa wapeza nchito.
For farmers, when it is raining well like it is doing here in Zambia,
walimi pomwe mvura ili kugwa bwino monga kuchitikira kuno Mzambia,
they rejoice.
Akondwera.
Because they know that the crop will have enough water.
Chifukwa dziwa kuti zishango zakhala nao madzi abwino.
And in a family where everyone is present and life is okay, they also rejoice.
Mubanja momwe wina ndi wina alipo zinthu zonse zienda bwino na oso akhala akukondwa.
Now Paul says rejoice always.
So pano mtumi Paulo akuti kondwerani nthawi zonse.
But when you look at these sources of joy,
pomwe muona komwe kuchokera zikondwererozi zina,
they are attached to some conditions.
Zalumikizidwa kumalamulo pena.
Think about health.
Talingalirani kumbali
ya. You may be enjoying health.
Mwina mwacho ngakhale
watanzi. But at some point you get sick.
Tawizi na uzadwa.
You go to the hospital.
Uzapita
uchipatara. So that joy which was caused by good health will no longer be there.
Chikondwerero icho chinabweretsedwa ndi thanzi labwino chikhala ndi kuchoka.
Maybe you have got some good economy, some good business.
Mwina mwacho ndi malonda abwino, ndi kobiri.
But certain conditions can take place that will affect the economy, that will affect the business.
Mavuto bena azachitika, omwe azakuza malonda ako.
Today think about the coronavirus.
Lero lino talingalirani kamba kakalombo ka corona.
The world economy is on its knees.
Sopano, madzikolonse la tuntu, la karanditu pankokola zache kumbali ya kobi.
People's businesses are affected.
Malonda antu osa karanditu kukunzi.
So that joy which was brought by good business and good economy is no longer there.
Chikondwele rochi, jachina bwere sedwa, tsono ndi malonda bwino, ndi kobiri, cha karanditu kuchoko.
Maybe you were employed.
Mwina mwache unali ndi nchito.
But then the company is not making enough profit. And then they are saying we are going to restructure and you won't be part of this organization.
So
that joy which was caused by the employment is no longer there.
Think
about farmers. Maybe it is raining very well. Farmers are filled with joy. But due to climate change, some seasons don't have enough rainfall. And that joy caused by good rain is no longer there because now there is drought. When everyone has got life in the family, we enjoy. But when one has been taken by death, that joy is no longer there. So the sources of joy on earth are temporal. Because they are attached to certain conditions. But the joy of a Christian must not depend on any special or specific mood or condition.
So pano chikondwelero cha mkirisitu chizakala ndi kulumikizidwa kwa zina ndi malamulo vena ndi zina zinthu ai.
Joy must fill us always.
Chikondwelero cheno kala chodzala mwa ife nthawi zonse.
Irrespective of the circumstances that we may be passing through in this life.
Kulibe ndava zotesa nzeru zomwe tipyolamo mu moyo wathu uwu.
Joy must be reflected in our deeds and in our actions and in our thoughts. Apostle Paul
Mutumi Paulo
issued this statement when he was in prison. Because there may be a thought that maybe he was leading a comfortable life, that's why he was saying, rejoice in the Lord always. But he was in prison. And yet he said, rejoice in the Lord always. He repeatedly professed Jesus Christ even when he was in prison. And he calls us to do the same. So, what are the reasons for this joy which Paul is talking about? Already we can refer to what our Lord Jesus Christ said, as recorded in the book of Luke chapter 10. When those 70 disciples returned, the ones he had sent, they were excited. And then they reported to Jesus Christ that we did everything you told us. And even the spirits, the demons were subject to us in your name. So Jesus Christ said, I gave you authority. Nevertheless, do not rejoice because the spirits were subject to you.
So pano anatanga karetero musasangalale kuti mizimu ya gonjera kwa inu.
But rejoice because your names are written in heaven.
Kondwerani kuti maina vanhu ngolembedwa mubuku la moyo.
That is in Luke chapter 10 verse 20.
So,
brothers and sisters, we want to rejoice because our names are written in heaven. But we must also continue doing God's will because our names can be rubbed if we are not doing God's will.
Now,
Paul offers one reason for joy. He says the Lord is at hand.
Anena kuti ambuye ali pafupi.
He mentions about the heretics in that time.
Alankula kamba kazochitika mtawi ija.
People who were more interested in earthly glory.
Antu omwe anali ndithu oikanzeru kulemerero wa dziko la
pansi. And he mentioned and made it clear that that glory is for a short period of time.
Koma anachika pamtetete kuti ulemerero umenewo unali koma wakanthawi.
And to the contrary, he said the true Christianity should always be oriented towards something other than earthly things.
Mosusana ndizo anati chikondwero ndipo sinimkhadwa mukhristu ukhale ndito kazikisidwa mutenga wa Kristo.
And what is that something he was referring to?
Kodi china chintucho chomwe anali kulankhula ndi chiti?
It's something which is written in the book of Philippians chapter 3 verse 20.
Ndi china cholembedwa mbuku la Filipo chigawo cha chitatu ndi ndime ya 20.
And that is connecting to the return of the Lord.
Izi zilumikizidwa kukubweranso kwa Mbuye.
It is said here.
Kunena a
for our citizenship is in heaven.
Koma ufulu watu ife ngwa kumwamba.
From which we also eagerly wait for the Savior.
Omwe nafeso tiyembekezera kupyola mwa mpulumutsi.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
Ambuye Yesu Kristu.
And that is a source of joy for you and me.
Uko ndikomwe kuchokera chikondwerero kwa iwe ndi ine.
The return of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Bweranso kwa mbuye wadu Yesu Kristu.
The other source of joy is the certainty of eternal life in the new creation.
Kochokeraso chikondwerero chathu so ndi kusimikizira kwa chilengedwe cha sopano.
We know that after the final judgment,
tidziwa kuti pambuyo pachiweruzo chomalizira,
there will be a new creation.
Kuzakhalaso chilengedwe cha sopano.
And it is written in the book of Revelations chapter 21.
Nikolembedwa mbuku la chivumbulutso tsamba 21.
That God will be with his people and they will be with him.
Sopano Mulungu azakhala ndi anthu acha azakhala naye.
He will be their God and they will be his people.
Iya zakhala Mulungu wawo anthuwo azakhalanso anthu ake.
He will wipe away the tears from their eyes.
Azapukuta misozi kumaso awo.
There will be no suffering.
Kusiku zakhalaso.
There will be no death.
Siku zakhalaso.
Everything will be okay.
Zinthu zonse zakhala bwino.
Now the certainty of that life after the final judgment is a source of joy for you and me.
Kusimikizira kwa umoyo uwo kumbuyo kwa chiwezo cha mapeto ndiko kuchokera chikondwerero chathu iwe ndi ine.
The statement of Paul that the Lord is at hand.
Koma mzera wochokera kwa Paulo akuti Ambuye ali pafupi.
Has a special and present aspect.
Uri nditheka wazimene zipezeka mtawi yathu iyi.
We also rejoice because Jesus Christ is present here and now in the congregation.
Tisangalalanso kutambie Yesu aliko tilinaye lero lino ndi nthawi imeneyi.
He is the head of his church.
Ndiye mutu wakachisi wake.
And he is always with his apostles.
Iye nthawi zonse ali ndi atumwi ache.
It is written in the book of Matthew.
Nkolembedwa mbuku la Mateo.
Where he said, I will be with you until the end of the age.
Komwe yana ati ndizakhala ndinu kufikira kumapeto anyengo.
So he is present in his church.
Alimo mukachisi wache.
How do we experience his nearness in the church?
Kodi tikumana ndi kupezekapo kwache motani.
Through the word in the divine services and also through the worthy celebration of Holy Communion.
Kupyorera muliwu la mapempero oyera ndi kutenga kombali kumgonero oyera munjira yoyenerera.
Here God is directly at work.
Pompa no Ambuye atumikira.
For the salvation of you and me.
Kuchipulumutso cha iwe ndi ili.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord.
Okondedwa abale ndi alonganga mwa Ambuye.
But we also experience the nearness of the Lord in everyday life.
Koma tikumana ndi nkopela Ambuye mu moyo wathu wa siku ndi siku.
We experience the nearness of the Lord when we pray.
Tikumana ndi kupezeka pafupi kwa Mbuye Yesu pomwe tipempera.
When we pray, we are direct into contact with God.
Pomwe tipempera ndiyeno tikhalalu akulumikizidwa ndi Ambuye.
And that experience should bring joy to you and me.
So pano mukukumana uku kuyenera kubweretsa chikondwerero kwa iwe.
That I'm now talking to God directly.
Kuti ine sono ndilankhula ndi Ambuye maso mpenya.
But when we pray, we must also be filled with humbleness.
Pomwe tipempera tikhale akudzala nako kuzichepetsa.
Because God will provide solutions to a humble supplicant.
Tsopano ambuya pereka mayanko kwa iwo zichepetsa.
Jesus Christ is present in our lives.
Ambuye Yesu ali mu moyo wathu.
He provides us with protection.
Atipatsa chitetezo.
Because he is omniscient, he is omnipotent.
Chifukwa iye ndiye wamuyaya ndiposa pezeka.
He knows everything.
Adziwa zinthu zonse.
He knows what is happening in your heart, he knows what is happening in my heart.
Adziwa zomwe zitenga malo mtima wako ndi mtima wanga.
He knows what is contained in the future.
Adziwa zimene zili
mtsogolo. And his desire is to save us.
Ndiposo chilakola ko chache ndi kutumikira kwa ife.
So he helps us to build our faith.
Atitandizira ife kumanga chikhulupiriro
chathu. My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord. So when we apply the beatitudes of Jesus Christ, the beatitudes as recorded in the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 1 to 12, when we apply those beatitudes seriously, we can experience anew a peace of heaven already on
earth.
And we can realize that Jesus is with us and is on our side.
Tingate kudzindikira kuti inde ambuya ali kumbali yathu ndiponso tili naye.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord.
Okondedwa abale ndi alongo anga mwa ambuye.
But for us to experience these sources of joy,
kwa ife kuti tikumane nazo izi komwe kuturuka chikondwere,
we need to do something.
Tienolo chita china.
And what is it that we should do for us to experience these sources of joy?
Ndichiyani chimene tienolo chita kuti ifeyo tikale nazo izi komwe kuchokera chikondwere?
We must do his will.
Tichite chifuniro chache.
When we practice the will of God,
pomwe tichita chifuniro chambu cha Mulungu,
we can already experience the reign of God manifesting itself here on earth.
So pano tinga kumane nako kulamulira kwa Mulungu kuli kuonekera mwa ife pano padziko la pano.
So my dear brothers and sisters, let us radiate the joy in Christ.
So pano kondedwa bale ndi alongo tienti pereke chikondwerero cha Kristu.
The joy in his presence here and now.
Chikondwerero cha kupezekapo kwache lero lino ndipo mpano.
The joy of his saving activity at his imminent return.
Ndiponso chikondwerero cha kutumikira kwafudza kwache mosa chedwa.
Brothers and sisters, this is the message for today.
Okondedwa abale ndi alongo undi wo utenga wasiku la.
The imminent return of Jesus Christ, as well as his present nearness in the congregations and in our lives, is a source of our joy.
Kuonekera kwa kudza kwache ndiponso ndizo kupezeka mu kwambi Yesu Kristu mitima yathu izomwe zidzetsa chikondwerero.
And we have also heard that the earthly joy is temporal.
Tamvaso kuti chikondwerero chapadziko lapansi ndi chakwa kanthawi.
Because death has got authority on earthly joy.
Chifukwa imfa ili nayo mphamvu kuchikondwerero chapadziko no lapansi.
So our joy should not be based on some mood or some conditions.
So pano chikondwerero chathu chisalumikizidwe kwa mala mulovena kapena mikhalidwe ina.
And for us to experience this joy,
mwaife kukumana nacho chikondwerero chache,
let us do his will.
Tieni tichite chifuniro chake.
And when we do that,
pomwe tichita izo,
we will please God.
Tidzakondweretsa Mulungu.
And we will be ready for his return.
Tidzakhala akukonzekera kubwera
kwake. And when he returns, he will find us ready.
Pomwe yaz
and in grace he will receive us to himself.
Pomwe yazabwera zatipeza tiri okonzekera ndiposo muchisomo azatitengera.
And we will be with him forever.
Tidzakhala naye kwa muyaya.
So rejoice in the Lord always.
Kondwerani kwa Ambuye nthawi
zonse. Again I say rejoice.
Ndibwezeranso kutero kondwerani.
Amen.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, the disapostle helper Robert Nsamba is also here. And the choir and the organ will play and sing, "Hosanna, blessed is he."
Oimba ndi wa organ azakhala ndi kuimba nyimbo, "Hosanna, ngodala ndi iye."
My beloved in the Lord, dear brothers and sisters and dear friends. We are being urged to be joyful all the time, not sometimes, but all the time. We've also heard the various sources of joy. And the one that stands out above all these sources. That if we do the will of God, then one might ask, how shall we do it? By putting his gospel into practice. Taking him as the standard in our lives. Being the great example ever experienced in one's life. To experience his nearness. To have an encounter with him in word and in sacrament. Then it doesn't matter what circumstances surround us. Because he says to us, fear not, my little flock, I'll be with you. In a moment, I'll come and take you home. And while we are waiting, we experience his presence. Then we want to encourage one another. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, let us say it, that we must rejoice in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Then the orchestra will play, "The Lord Shall Come." And from Malawi, the Apostle Owen Kaira will come and serve along.
Chokera ku Malawi, mutumwi Owen Kaira azabwera na azatumikira.
My dear brothers and sisters, dear friends and guests. Our dear district apostle has led us wonderfully on this
word.
The reason for us to rejoice always is that The Lord is always near us.
Chifukwa chakuti ife tikhale okondwera nthawi zonse nchakuti Ambuye nthawi zonse ali nafe.
He will not only save us when he takes us into his kingdom.
Sazatumikira chabe pamene azatitenga ife kupita mu ufumu wake.
He is already with us.
Ndiye ali nafe kale.
The knowledge that the one who is with us is greater than everything. That knowledge should make us joyful always. It is to that effect that even the psalmist could say,
Nimwa chifukwa ichi mwakuti wa masalimo analankhula kuti
Where can I go from your spirit?
Nzapita kuti kuchoka kumzimu wanu?
Or where can I flee from your presence?
Kodi nzathavira kuti kuchoka kwa inu?
If I ascend into heaven, you are there.
Nitakwera upita kumyamba inu muliko.
If I make my bed in hell, even there, you are there.
Ngakhanta nzika khamalanga mugehena momwenso mulimo.
That is a reference to the saving hand of God, even to the souls that have gone into the beyond.
Ndiye cherekezo chakutumikira ngakhale iwo anapita muziko la msidi.
He continues to say, if I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the earth,
Ndiye alankhulanso kuti ngakhale nditatenga mapiko amba ndakucha ndi kupita patali.
Even there, your hand shall lead me.
Ndipo ngakhale komweko mudzanditsogolera.
Your right hand shall hold me.
Ndiye dzanja lanu lamanja lidzanigwiririra.
This knowledge that God is with us everywhere we are should make us rejoice. Should make us not fear anything. That is why the same apostle wrote to the Romans, rejoicing in hope. Patient in tribulation and continuing steadfastly in prayer. In this manner, the one whose presence should make us rejoice always. Will take us home and will rejoice forever.
Azati tenga upita kumunzi ndipo tizakondwera kwa muyaya.
Amen.
On account of time, the choir will not sing.
Kamba kanthawi oimba sazaimba.
But from Harare in Zimbabwe, the apostle Daniel Mulemba will come and serve alone.
Mutumi Daniel Mulemba azabwera na azatumikira.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters, here and in the connected congregations, I also want to thank God, but also I rejoice to be part of this festive divine service. A special word has been given to us. Rejoice in the Lord. The source of our joy is in the Lord. That is why when the Lord Jesus Christ was born and the choir sings, joy to the world. The Lord Jesus Christ brings joy. And today is the fourth Sunday of Advent. We are further reminded. This Jesus that came, he is going to come again. Rejoice.
Because he wants to take you with him. Rejoice. Because he is with you even now. Rejoice. Because God loves you. Amen.
Amen.
So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us always rejoice in the Lord. And so for Paul to even repeat that again, I say rejoice, it means he was convinced.
So pano Paulo mwakunena kuti ndi kotero ndibwezeranso kuti kondwerano anali tantauzira kuti anali okhutira.
He knew about the certainty of his future.
Anali kudzindikira kusimikizira kwatsogolo lake.
We also have the certainty of our future.
Nafeso
in the Lord.
And
so we have heard a lot. And to conclude this sermon, the choir will sing, Jesus, thou art our salvation.
Yesu ndiwe chipulumutso chathu.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters in the Lord, it's time now for us to be forgiven our sins. It is written that man has fallen short of God's glory. And that is because of sin. But we have an advantage because the Lord is ready to forgive us. But before he forgives us, we must be sincere with ourselves.
So pano pomwe akalibe kuti kururukira tenera kukhala nalo zedi mwa ife toka.
We cannot play hide and seek games with God because he sees everything and he's everywhere.
Sono stinga chite sopano kabisa bisa chifukwa iye adziwa zose.
And even before we sin, he knows that we are going to do this wrong thing. So when we want to be forgiven, we must go to him in sincerity. Because what he merely wants from us is a confirmation that we know that what we've done is wrong.
So pano chomwafuna kwa ife ndi kukhala akunena zaife kuti iso adzindikire kuti tidziwa kuti talapo.
Not that he doesn't know, he knows everything.
Sikutantauzira kuti sadziwa, ai iye adziwa.
He wants a confirmation.
Koma afuna kuti simikizire ife toka.
We also need to forgive others because that is a serious condition for us to be forgiven our sins.
Nafeso tena kukhululukira vena chifukwa ndi lolamulo lalikulu lopatsidwa kuti nafeso tikhale kukhululukira.
It is said that if you forgive other people their trespasses, your heavenly Father will forgive you.
Kunenedwa kuti pomwe ukhululukira vena mpulumpulu zawo ndiyeno naweso zakhala kukhululukidwa machimo
ako. We must also establish a new direction.
Tena sopano kupedza njira sopano.
Repentance is very, very important.
Kulapa ndi chinthu chofunikira.
And establish a new direction.
Na kazikisa njira ya sopano.
Then the forgiveness will be effective.
So
as we are reflecting on many things which we've done that are not pleasing before God, as a congregation, we are going to sing while seated. I want a principle within. Stand up and say the prayer which the Lord Jesus Christ taught us.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
I proclaim unto you the glad tidings. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, your sins are forgiven. The peace of the risen one abide with you. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, loving Father, for everything. Thank you for the word. And Father, thank you also for the forgiveness of our sins. We do not want to take anything for granted. But we know also that there is time when we can go astray. When that happens, Father, do not leave us alone. But call us back and lead us home. We are grateful that your Son, Jesus Christ, came to die for us, and that through his sacrificial death, we have been reconciled with you. Help us, Father, that our conduct should befit the sacrifice of your Son. He also created the sacrament of the Holy Communion, which your Son, Jesus Christ, prepared. So come now and sanctify us, so that as we come to partake of this sacrament, we may do so with worthiness. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And now we are going to celebrate Holy Communion. And now the Lord's table is prepared. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I consecrate bread and wine for the Holy Communion. And lay thereupon the once brought eternally valid sacrifice of Jesus Christ. For the Lord took bread and wine, gave thanks and said, "This is my body which is broken for you. This is my blood of the new covenant given for many for the remission of sins. Eat and drink. Do this in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this wine, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes." Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Body of Jesus given for you. Amen. The body and blood of Jesus given for you. The body and blood of Jesus given for you. The body and blood of Jesus given for you.
Amen.
The body and blood of Jesus given for you.
Amen.
The body and blood of Jesus given for you.
Amen.
The body and blood of Jesus given for you.
Amen.
the congregation can sit.
Mpingo nga kalepans.
Serving ministers, please take up your postures. There are two Holy Communion hymns for the congregation. There is a fountain fresh from the throne of glory in Lozi. If there will be requirement for singing, you will be guided thereafter. The Lord now invites you to Holy Communion.
Thank you.
verse of Fresh from the Throne.
Imeimodzi yokaya nyimbo zochokera kumpando wa Mbuye.
My beloved in the Lord, dear brothers and sisters, our dear disciples now proceed to serve Holy Communion to our beloved ones from the underworld. The two district directors, Stumbeko Muita and Wisdom Shanengeta, will be used as proxy.
So, pano iyo tsogolera zigao awiri vazabwera kugwirisidwa ntchito.
Then us as a congregation, as a preparation, we shall sing one verse only, All the Home of My Soul is on High.
So pano munga mpingo tizaimba ndime imodzi yoka ya nyimbo, mudzi wa moyo wanga.
Congregation can stand. Now, Jesus Christ invites you, dear brothers and sisters, from the beyond.
So, pano ambuye Yesu akumemedza nokondedwa bale ndi alongo choka mala mtsidi.
That come, you who are redeemed.
Idzani inu.
Come, you who are waiting for the return of Jesus Christ, just like ourselves.
Idzani inu nonso mwembekezera kubwera kwa mbuye Yesu monga na fenso tiembekezera.
Come, many of you pioneers of this work.
Idzani unyinji wa inu ndinu ayambi anchitoi.
Come and receive that which I'm now placing in the hands of the two district directors.
Idzani mzalandire zomwe ndikazikisa mumanja ya tsogoleri azigawo awiri.
The body and blood of Jesus.
Topi ndi mwazi wa Yesu.
Given for you.
Zipatsidwa kwa inu.
For your peace. For your comfort.
Kamba kachitontozo chanu.
And for your eternal life.
Ndi umoyo o sata.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. We can. Now we can close with a prayer.
So pano tingatseke mpempero.
Thank you, loving Father in heaven.
Zikomo atete watu wachikondi wakumwamba.
Thank you for that which we have experienced this morning.
Zikomo kwa zomwe takumana nazo mbabamu.
You have visited us, Father, and you have given us the word.
Mwatichezera na tipatsa liu.
Help us to implement the word you have given us.
Titandizireni kuti tichite mmonga mwaliu mwatipatsa.
Help us to always focus on doing your will.
Titandizireni kuti tipenyerere mwakuchita chonchito yanu.
From here we'll be going to various destinations.
Tikachoka muno tipita mmadera mwatu mosiyana siyana.
Travel with us, Father, so that we can reach safely.
Yenda ninafe atate kuti tikafike mwamtendere.
Receive and bless the offerings of your children.
Landirani na darisa nsembe za ana anu.
And help them when they are in difficulties.
Ana watandizira pomwe akumana ndi mavuto.
Deal with those that are passing through various problems.
Karani nao iwo omwe akumana ndi mavuto siyana siyana.
And bless your work, Father.
Na darisa nchito yanu atate.
Let it grow to reach the level that you desire.
Itandizirani kuti ikule nafika pamsinko mamufuna.
Bless your servants.
Darisana nchito bana.
And provide everything to your high servant, the chief apostle.
Patsani zofunikira zonse kwa okondedwa mtumwa wa Mungu.
So that he can continue guiding us to the goal of our faith.
Kutapitirizebe kutitsogolera kupita kuchipata cha chikhulupiriro.
We continue praying because of the coronavirus.
Tipitizabe kupempera kwa abale vathu.
Help us, Father, so that this disease can be defeated.
Titandizirana atate kuti matenda ava ate.
That we can start doing things in a normal way.
Kuti tiyambe kuchita zinthu monga mwakale.
Loving Father in heaven.
Wachikonda atate wakumwamba.
Now let the chief apostle always cover us with his prayers.
Lolani mtumwa mukulu atipimbe mapempero ache nthawi zonse.
We can't put everything in word.
Stingate kuika zonse mmawu.
Father, you know what we need.
Mudziwa zonse wazathu.
So give us much more than we can ask.
Tipatseni kuposa zomwe tingapempe.
Hear us, we ask in Jesus' name.
Timverereni tipempa mudzina la Yesu.
Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, even those that are connected to Lusaka Central this morning, I'm grateful and humbled that the Lord permitted us to be together this morning. Let us remain steadfast in our faith. And let us always continue rejoicing in the Lord.
Tikupitirizebe kukhala kukondwa mwa Ambuye.
And so, to close this divine service,
tsono mwakuseka mapempero oyera apa.
All of us, including those in the connected congregations,
tosefe ndiwo olumikizidwa ndi mpingo olumikizidwa.
As a congregation, we're going to sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Monga mpingo tizaimba nyimbo Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Two verses.
Ndime zwiri.
congregation can sit. Maybe I wanted to take advantage and appreciate the presence of the three disapostles in retirement.
So pano hapa ndifuna kutokoza tenga nthawi kuti litokoze iwo atumwi omwe anakhala ndi kuyikidwa mpumulo.
Three of them.
Atatu.
The disapostle Duncan Mfune.
Mutumwi wachigawo Duncan Mfune.
The disapostle Shadrach Luwasi, who served in East Africa. And the disapostle Charles Sakavumbi Ndandula. Maybe they can stand so that the congregation can see them. And I also want to recognize and appreciate the presence of the retired apostles.
Ndifuna tsopano kulankula kwa kutokoza kupezeka kwa atumwi omwe anapumulisidwa.
The Apostle Musaka.
Mutumwi Musaka.
The Apostle Samalama.
Mutumwi Samalama.
The Apostle Sweta.
Ndi mutumwi Sweta.
And they are accompanied by Bishop Muchimba.
Babwera mulendo wabwera ndi Bishop Skofu Muchimba.
And the other bishop. Maybe yes. They can stand so that the congregation can
see.
Thank you very much. My dear brothers and sisters, may God be with you. May He protect you. May He sustain your faith. Until we meet again. Vaye!
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 Bye.
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 And so now the choir and the orchestra will sing as we go.
So pano oimba ndoliza vilimba azaimba pomwe tiri kutuluka pabwalo.
Joy to the world.
Chikondwerero chikhale mdziko.
Bye.